One of the most common questions that I receive from mothers as a dental surgeon is this: when should I expect my baby's teeth to pop up? Because it seems it's taking forever. Well, as a parent, I do understand, because I also anxiously waited for my daughter's teeth to pop, even though I was a dentist. So grab your pen and paper and let me tell you everything you need to know about the eruption of milk teeth. So let's go. First, there are three important things that you need to know about the eruption of milk teeth. The first one is this: even though it is not common, it is perfectly normal for a baby to be born with teeth. And even the ones that are born without teeth, the ones we consider to be normal babies, actually have all their 20 teeth present under the gum, even though you don't see them. This is because the development of milk teeth is almost complete by the 5th month in pregnancy. The second thing you should note is that not every child is going to follow this pattern that we are going to talk about. So if your own child deviates, that is also perfectly normal. The third thing is that girls generally tend to get their teeth earlier than the boys. The schedule we are going to talk about is an average schedule in which you should expect your baby's teeth to pop. My name is Dr. Emmanuel Amukun from Marvel's Dental Hospital in Busia, Uganda. So let's dive in. For a better understanding of what we are going to talk about next, let's take a look at this diagram here. As you can see, at the very top, we have the first incisors, what we call the central incisors. Next, we have the second incisors, or the teeth next to the middle incisors. After that, we have the canines. And after the canines, we have the first molar, and then we have the second molars. At this point, you could be wondering, so where are the premolars? Well, babies don't have premolars, and that's why they have 20 teeth as opposed to 32 teeth in an adult. They also do not have third molars. And since the teeth on the left and the right, and the upper jaw and the lower jaw are similar, we do not need to waste time naming all of them. These are the only ones you need to remember, because we are going to refer to them as we move along. So the eruption of milk teeth actually happens in 10 steps. The very first step is the eruption of the lower central teeth, the lower central incisors, the middle teeth of the lower jaw. And this happens between the ages of 6 and 10 months. In the second step, we have the eruption of the upper central teeth, the upper first incisors, which happens between the ages of 8 and 12 months. And since the lower teeth came first, you'd be expecting that the second incisors to come first should be from the lower jaw. But no, it will be from the upper jaw. And the eruption of the upper second incisors happens at the ages between 9 and 13 months. Then in step 4, we now have the eruption of the second incisors of the lower jaw. And the eruption of these lower second incisors happens between the ages of 10 to 16 months. At this point, the baby has 4 teeth up and 4 teeth down, and they'll be able to flash you a beautiful toothy smile. From the second incisors, you would expect that the next teeth should be the canines. But no, in step 5, we shall get the first molars of the upper jaw at the ages between 13 to 19 months. But these are going to just sit there and sleep. At this point, they are not doing much, until their lower counterparts come, which are going to pop out at the ages between 14 and 18 months. And at this point, once the upper and the lower are there, then the molars can be put to good use, and your baby can enjoy some serious chewing. Sometimes though, instead of the first upper molars to come first, and then followed by the lower first molars, you might have a situation where the first molars of the left, both up and down, or the right, both up and down, first come before the other side. If this happens to your own baby, this is also perfectly normal. If you find any value in this video, please give it a thumbs up. And if you haven't yet subscribed, please hit that red subscribe button right now and join the family of confident smiles. So after our lower first molars, then we can have now the canines. The canines are coming to fill up the gap that was skipped when we got the first molar after the second incisor. And here also, the upper canines will come first, Canines, depending on what your teacher taught you. But for now, let's call them canines. The upper canines will come at the ages between 16 and 22 months. In step 8, these are going to be closely followed by the lower canines that are going to come out at the ages between 17 and 23 months. In step 9, now we stop popping upper teeth first and we start popping the lower teeth first. So in this stage, we'll have the lower second molars pop up before the upper. And this will happen at the ages between 23 and 31 months. After that, then now we have the upper second molars. And these ones are going to pop up between the ages of 25 and 33 months. So by the age of 3 years, a majority of babies have a full set of 20 teeth and they'll be able to give you that beautiful, beautiful grin. But don't worry if your own baby does not have 20 teeth by the time they are 3 years. One other thing you need to note is that this teething, exciting as it is, tends to come along with its own challenges, what we call teething challenges, or what people call teething problems. And these could actually give you sleepless nights if you don't know how to handle them. But don't worry, everything you need to know about handling teething problems is right in this video here. Click on it and watch, and I'll see you in the next one.